Did you pick this article for me? Okay, anyway. In Take Back Your Shit news submitted by I Know Kung Fu, the president of the Philippines threatens to go to war with Canada over rotting garbage.
What?
But why about that, Canada?
But why would they do that?
What? Why attack Canada? Canada out of all countries?
Because from what I've read,
no one has
Canada's in the wrong.
What did Canada do?
Canada's in the wrong.
Are they dumping illegal trash in the Philippines?
Canada. So there was this private company from Canada that shipped over a whole bunch of containers back in 2013.
Take your shit and go back home.
Get
out of here.
They improperly labeled it as recyclables.
Recyclables?
So they found out that it was actually home trash, like home use trash. It wasn't.
They lie.
What is this diaper doing here? This is not recycled.
They found adult diapers.
Like the pants?
That's disgusting.
Get out of here.
Get out.
So then it's just the elderly Korean. What the fuck, Canadians?
Koreans?
Freaking putang.
Yeah, so they're saying that it has been sitting in the Philippines for about 6 years, and now...
6 years.
Why did they let it sit there for so long?
Because Canada won't take it back. They keep giving Philippines like this runaround of like, oh, we'll get to it, and they never do. So it's been 6 years, and now the president he's saying that he will declare war.
Oh my god, come on.
Who's too gangster?
He's hella gangster though.
If they don't deal with this situation.
Is that with Canada or is it with that private company that sent it? It
kind of seemed like it was a government issue for a second there.
Yeah.
Well, it should. I mean, I guess it should.
Maybe government's not enforcing it, so they're just making him responsible.
Responsibility, yeah. Exactly.
He just needs to get Filipino trash and put it in Canada.
Yeah.
I feel like I would have done the same. I would have just done that, you know?
I feel like Filipino trash is way stinkier.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. Because it's tropical, yeah. It's all rotting and shit.
It's all fucking hot and fucking moist.
I'm going to bring the biggest stink bomb ever known to mankind.
If you don't take this, we're going to give you 8 gallons of balut right now.
All the balut of Philippines will be in Canada.
8 barrels of this.
Let me show you guys a video clip.
You guys really practiced that accent, man. It is
a lot of Filipino people.
Well done.
Yeah.
I'm going to
show you guys a video clip of the president.
I love this guy, dude.
He's
I hate him.
So gangster.
I want a boat prepared. I'll give a warning to Canada maybe next week. Better.
He's not even sure.
We'll declare war against them. Loaded the containers to a ship and advise Canada. I will advise Canada that your garbage is on the way. Prepare a grand reception.
Reception.
Eat it if you want to.
Ooh.
Your garbage is coming home.
I mean, why did they just do that? Put all the containers on the ship and just send it back?
Because that's not their problem. It's Canada's problem.
Well, no, it's not Canada's problem. It's their problem.
Well, and it kind of sucks
too. Complaining
because
about it.
I think what they're saying is it's Canada's responsibility, so they don't want to get their hands dirty. So they're like, the paperwork is in your hands. Just take care of it. But I think it's been waiting too long.
And it sucks because the Philippines is already a small island in itself. And if you're leaving your fucking trash there, I mean, come on. They don't have much land anyways.
Yeah.
So they got scammed by a Canadian company.
Yeah, I thought it was it's a private company though.
Yeah.
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 It's nothing to do with us.
So they're saying that those shipments, it violates multiple parts of the Basel Convention.
The Basel Convention?
Basel.
No,
what about what does the Parsley Committee have to say about this shit?
We want none of that.
It's a 30-year-old treaty that Canada signed back in 1989 that prevents countries from shipping hazardous waste to the developing world without their consent.
Because been doing that before? Damn, that's fucked up.
Oh, that makes sense.
I get why they would do that.
Weak countries, unstable governments. Yeah, you could just dump trash and they can't do nothing.
Yeah, you could take advantage of that.
So sad.
Damn, that's a country straight punk in another country.
Yeah.
I mean, that's why a lot of third world countries don't ever come out of poverty, because the rest of us exploit their resources and take everything that they got. Mm-hmm.
I want to visit the Philippines really bad.
Me too.
Dude, their waters look crazy with all those diapers in it.
Yeah.
I've never seen that part. I just seen tropical paradises.
No, I don't know that. But I just saw their waters look super
super blue. Yeah.
You know, Ken was just there. Ken and Bree. It looks beautiful.
Is
I don't know.
Brienne of Tarth. Is she Filipino?
Yeah, she's half white. Half Filipino.
Ooh.
Yeah.
Actually, it's interesting because there's a city in Canada, like right in its geographical center, Winnipeg.
I heard of Winnipeg.
Winnipeg has one of the largest Filipino populations outside of the Philippines. There's a huge Filipino population the first Jollibee that opened in Canada opened in Winnipeg, Manitoba.
He's good.
Jollibee's one of those things, man. It's like, it's, that's some hood ass food.
So then, are you saying that to create some sort of like peace treaty right now? Like for your country?
Just be in, yeah, it's interesting. I mean, he's, you know, like.
How could you treat us this way? You have Jollibee in Winnipeg? Yeah. How dare you?
Yeah, just there's a lot of Filipino Canadians out there.
Yeah, that's
true. Also, he's, I love, I will get in touch maybe next week.
Yeah, maybe. If he's not, it just looked like the chillest fucking meeting ever. Like,
I thought they were on a potluck or
right?
something.
Right? Like they just finished bingo and they're like, what do we talk about?
For real, I will declare war on
him. Maybe.
Maybe.
Maybe next.
He's done some crazy ass shit though. Like anybody who's any type of drug user, if you, even if you're using or selling it, yeah, you just get shot.
Yeah, yeah, yeah. He's like, I have spilled blood myself.
Oof.
That's crazy,
yeah.
Dude.
Yeah, he's a hell of a.
And it's so weird because it's so violent, and I guess like I don't know what's going on. It's not my country. I don't live there, right? But I guess, in his words, he was like, everybody has tried to do it their way, and since I've done it this way, I've actually made an effect. It worked. You know, either people are running away or they're stopped doing it out of fear. But out of everybody that's been in office, and he's one of those politicians that actually came from the scummiest areas and worked his way up. So he's not from like some type of like really strong lineage or anything like that, or people who have money. Mm-hmm. So I guess like he was voted up to there, right? Or something like that.
Well, he's creating stability too, because my friend's dad, well, he's half Filipino, half Japanese, and his dad does real estate in the Philippines. And he says that now there's more faith in the economy because there's stability and less corruption in real estate. So then people are putting money into the country, they're developing homes and all that stuff without being worried of like the government's gonna fuck them through paperwork or anything else. There's more of that trust and stability going on because
they're killing people on the
because he's making sure that corrupt, well, that's just a drug thing. He's draconian with the drugs, but also with corruption. So he's actually making people that are scamming and being corrupt and using their abuse of power, he's holding them accountable for that stuff.
Just like how he's holding Canada accountable for the 103 shipping containers.
Right, so that it might seem extreme, but I also think like they're different from our country. Like they need this. Like they're so corrupt, they're so unstable that they need somebody to come in like a dad and just fucking put their foot down and make sure that things are running right. Because everyone's just in it for themselves and how they're scamming the system.
Because I was reading a couple articles where they were just talking about, I mean, obviously people, he's doing it a bit out of fear once you start just killing people off. But at the same time, I feel like from what I've read, a majority of people love this guy.
Yeah.
They actually like it because he's actually creating positive change.
Yeah, it's effective.
Crazy.
That's why I think like you got to do it in stages, right? If your whole country's all fucked up and it's full of corruption and you don't know how to like wrangle people, you got to use negative reinforcement, because I think they're just babies at that moment. And
corruption.
Then, yeah, until you get everybody together on the same group mind, I don't know how you can do it if you don't rule with the iron fist. I don't even know. I'm just kind of like jealous because I wish I was a dictator.
He just looks like somebody's uncle like karaoke's every weekend.
I know, right?
I bet you he does that for fun. Can we sing a Whitney Houston again?
The fucking karaoke mic with all the numbers and stuff on it. You
know, and running. That crazy ass echo and reverb where the whole neighborhood could hear it.
So you think he's more like a dictator then?
Yeah, he's for sure.
Oh, for sure.
But sometimes also, you need a dictator.
Yeah, I think every country's different, right? Because they all have... Every country has different problems. Like, I don't think he's needed here because there's more accountability.
And look at the size of the Philippines.
Yeah.
It's a small island.
And so it's spread. A lot more manageable. It's all over the place.
True.
With different languages and all that. I think it's just, it's a lot more difficult to get everybody on the same page working together, especially when you don't have resources and money. That's hard as hell. That's why we can't look at shit from like a developed nation's point of view and then be like judgmental, like, oh,
sure.
Look at this fucking... Even North Korea, right? Like, you look at a country like that, it's like they're holding on to dear life so they don't become infiltrated by the Western powers and basically be taken out. Like, all these third world countries are taken out by us and we exploit their resources for whatever, you know, profit that we can gain. It's usually tied to oil or whatever resources. Like Venezuela, what's happening right now, we destabilize Venezuela and we're going after their oil, like we did with the Middle East. And people don't want to really understand or see how that happens. It's just overall, like, we keep staying number one. Us, as in, like, Western nations, we stay number one by exploiting them.
And then we sit back and we judge their, like, principles, yeah, and their ideologies, and we call them draconian and, yep, and old and, like, yep, inhumane and whatever.
Mm-hmm.
Although I will say, I mean, not having the ability to defend yourself before you get killed because you have drugs is...
That's pretty fucked up.
No, I take your point about not being overly Western-centric with, yeah, the way that we look at other
countries. And a lot of times we prop up the leaders too.
Yeah.
Yeah, like we propped up Saddam, we propped up Osama,
mm-hmm,
we propped up Gaddafi.
Mm-hmm.
Like a lot of them we funded, we helped bring them up. And then when they turned their backs on the U.S., meaning like they don't want to listen to the orders anymore, we take them out.
I just watched Good Will Hunting the other day. I don't know if you guys know that movie well.
Yeah. I love it.
With Matt Damon.
But Matt Damon has this whole monologue about, like, because he's interviewing the NSA, and they're like, and he's like, why should I work with the NSA? And the guy's like, well, we're of, like, top technology. We're the, smartest minds in the world. Like, why shouldn't you work for the NSA? And he goes into this whole tirade about how, like, he has this buddy that goes off to fight a war, but he comes back only to find that he can't find a job because all the jobs in oil went to the people that he, like, bombed in the, yeah, Middle East. It's a great monologue. It's one of my favorite movies.
I like Lord of War.
Lord of War?
With Nicolas Cage.
I love Nicolas Cage.
Yeah.
Just in general.
It was dope.